Hi, my name is Sonia.
And I'm Zoe.
And we are nuclear medicine technologists.
At Royal Perth Hospital.
All right, what I'll get you to do is to lie down again for me, head on the pillow. Just bring your body towards me a little bit.
I really enjoyed maths at school and really wanted to pursue something with that. But when I looked at those careers, they were all things that involved not that much person-to-person contact.
I wasn't keen on sitting at a computer all day or doing calculations all day. I really wanted to work with people, and this is the ideal job for it.
I could combine my love of maths, which I suppose not a lot of people have, but yeah, my love of maths with this job, which yeah, I really enjoy, and everything else about it as well.
Now, you're having a heart scan. Have you ever had one done before?
No.
No? Okay. What this test does is it looks at how your heart's beating, how it's functioning. Okay. Now, is this arm okay to use for injections?
Yeah, that's fine.
Small sting coming up, Sally.
There we go. That's the worst part done.
So I'm just going to make up what we call MAG3, which is a renal tracer, so it's to image the kidneys. So for this particular kit, we need 2 gigabecs. So it's saying that we've got 7.57 gigabecs. And if I refer to my little notes, we've got about 5.7 mils in that vial. So from there, you've got to calculate the volume you've got to draw up to get a certain amount of activity.
People automatically think radiation, Chernobyl.
By the time you get to actually working on the job, it's second nature. It's always in the back of your mind, and you can't be scared of it, but you've got to treat it with respect.
After 6 hours, half of what we put into you, the radiation, half of that will be gone. So if you want to eliminate it quickly from your body, the best thing you can do is have lots of fluids to drink. So the more you drink, the faster you get rid of your radiation.
Okay.
Relax, breathe normally. Nice and still for me, that one's underway. This is the process data, so this is coming straight off the camera. It's been summed into a whole lot of projections and turned into that 3D picture. This is the heart in the stressed state. They've got a little bit of non-activity in that region. Our decisions, our diagnosis can decide what management they have. They're a little, one step closer to a healthier life.
This patient had a knee replacement and now he's having ongoing pain. So we're assessing to see, it would be anything like if he's got infection, if that would be the source of his pain, if he's got inflammation. That's his left knee there, and you can see it's not bright like the other knee because there's no bone there, because that's where they replaced the bone. That area there is what we call quite hot, which means there's a lot of counts, a lot of radiation being emitted from there. So that could be anything like infection or a fracture or something like that.
Time management and organisation is imperative. It's something you learn with the more experience you have. You get better at knowing, okay, I think this is going to take this long. I better move this patient onto this camera. And it's definitely something that you improve with. And it's also something that by watching the more experienced technologists, I find that's a really good way of learning sort of, you know, little organisational tips and things. But it's just something you get used to and sort of become second nature.
One of the hardest parts of our job is probably when you're doing a scan and you can see the results before your eyes, even before the doctor's reported the scan. You can see that the prognosis isn't good. When they ask you, oh, is my scan okay, or did you see anything, we're not allowed to tell them anything. And if you have one that's quite calm about it, then you can get out of it easily. But you do get the ones that won't leave you alone, and that can get a bit awkward. But once again, that's something you get used to with experience.
I have this motto: patients never remember what you did, patients never remember what you say, but they'll always remember how you made them feel. If you make someone feel uncomfortable, that's it. See you later. They won't come back to us. They'll tell all their friends that it wasn't a cool experience.
They do come down and feel like someone's actually listening to them, and yeah, Someone actually cares about their well-being, especially when they tell you or you tell a fellow staff member that you've done a good job. That's a great feeling. Yeah.